Good day, my name's Larry Klayman. You know me as the founder of both Judicial Watch and now Freedom Watch. I'm currently the chairman and general counsel of Freedom Watch. Go to freedomwatchusa.org. I've also formed a new group with Sheriff Joe Arpaio, America's Toughest Sheriff, americassheriff.org. Two S's in the middle. Go there and support both of these groups because we need to take action. Now is not the time just to write books. I've written books. It takes a revolution, forget the scandal industry. Before that, horrors, why and how I came to fight the establishment. Before that, fatal neglect, how the government dropped the ball on 9/11. But now is not just the time to write. Our founding fathers wrote, Thomas Paine wrote. He told people that it was not the time for sunshine patriots and summer soldiers. And clearly it's not the time now. It's good to get the people educated. But we now see, every single day, another tragedy befalling upon this country. Today, Afghanistan is collapsing. We shouldn't even been there in the first place other than to remove the Taliban and Al-Qaeda. We've lost thousands and thousands of lives. But to leave in this way, in total disgrace, tells the rest of the world the American people will not stand up for its allies, that we will abandon. Under President Biden and the Democrats, this is a constant theme. They will abandon anyone. They've abandoned the American people. And so too have the Republicans. The Democrat Party is pure evil. The Republican Party is simply corrupt. Ask how many times in the course of a day you get emails asking for money. What have they done? They got us in a war in Afghanistan, the Republicans and the Democrats. They gave us Obamacare, which bankrupted the country. They, of course, did other things which gave rise to the situation we're in now. And look at what's happening in addition to Afghanistan. People running across the border from the southern hemisphere, hundreds of thousands, if not millions, carrying COVID-19, drug traffickers, human traffickers, infecting our country with deadly disease. Look at what's happening with regard to our economy. Our economy is collapsing. Price of oil is going way up. Now Biden is having to get down on his knees to the Saudis and the rest and say, produce more oil, after he cut off the Alaska oil pipeline and limited the production in this country otherwise. Look at what's happening with regard to COVID-19. We don't even know what this Delta variant is, really. Is it COVID-19? Or is it Spanish flu, which Fauci admits that he was playing around with years ago in gain-of-function research? Did it get out? Is it a bigger pandemic than we even know about? Look at the drug companies who haven't told us of all the various reactions that occur. Look at the pregnant women who have taken it, or women that want to have children that didn't know that it wasn't properly tested. The government and the drug companies are not telling us the truth, and certainly they're not telling us the full truth. Look at our election system, which is in shambles. There's no longer any recourse at the ballot box because the system is so corrupt top to bottom. Regardless of whether there was massive fraud or not, the vote in ballot, the mail-in ballot system is fraught with fraud. In various states, whether it's California, New York, or others, illegal aliens can get a driver's license and vote. They send you paper ballots. Then you can go into the voting place and they'll say, what, do you want to vote electronically? And they give you another paper ballot. In California, you can vote three times or more. This is what we are dealing with. So we don't even know that the people we elect were properly elected. I can go on and on. But then there was January 6th, when the American people saw just how corrupt the three branches of government is or are. And they rose up. And the final straw was the federal judiciary, which Thomas Jefferson said we become despots and tyrants because they're unelected and unaccountable to the people, causing us to shed the blood of patriots and tyrants again about every 20 years or so, adding what's a few thousand dead to refresh the tree of liberty. He did not want to see anyone dead or hurt, neither do I. My book, It Takes a Revolution, has peaceful and legal means to now wage what is a counter-revolution because the left has taken total control. It has basically put a noose around our neck in a virtual dictatorship of socialism, communism, atheism, and every other radical ideology which has infested the White House through the two stooges, Biden and Harris, who just rubber stamp what the radical left wants. And when the people rise up in protest, as they did at the Capitol, and most of those people overwhelmingly were peaceful, they came in, they were let in by the police. That's a dirty little secret, most of them. There were some criminals on both sides, and they deserve what they get, but the overwhelming majority were peaceful. They saw that the judges did not even stand up for a president that appointed them on the Supreme Court justices, the lower court judges, Republican-appointed Trump judges, getting there through what amounts basically to bribes, campaign contributions to put them on the bench, campaign contributions not just by themselves, but by special interest groups, and then sleazy lobbyists from the American Conservative Union and the Federalist Society that want their yes men on the bench. The American people see through this, and they understand that we have no government. The situation is worse than it was in 1776. King George III was not a socialist. King George III was not a communist. King George III was not an atheist. He was not a radical Muslim. He was not a member of the Marxian Jewish left. And you know that I'm Jewish Christian, so no one can accuse me of being anti-Semitic. But I call people out who claim to be Jews that they're not. These people are not Jews. They're Marxists. And they're a bad example for the rest of us. Turn on CNN, see who they are. Most of them are commentators. Media. In the 20-some years that I've been doing what I do, these are the people that have attacked me the most. These are the people that want to destroy Israel because they're Marxists. And then you've got radical feminists, radical gays, lesbians, transgenders. You've got radicals of every stripe, radical blacks. Most of the people in these groups are good and decent people. But the radical people have seized control of this country, and they have control of the government. They have Biden and Harris by the proverbial cojones. So we need to rise up, ladies and gentlemen, peacefully and legally. The time is short for this country to survive. It will not survive a year in terms of the way it's going right now. So I want you to go out and read my book. Read Mark Levin's book if you want. He has no solutions. He just tells you that we live in Marxism. His solution is, well, let's protest. Let's boycott. Okay, let's complain. Well, that's not enough. You'll sell a million books, Mark. But that's not enough. We need real action. We need to take our legal system back. We need to have citizens' grand juries, which we have a right to do, as Justice Scalia wrote in a majority opinion in 1992, United States versus Williams, that the grand jury belongs to the American people. These criminals that run our government need to be held accountable. We've already indicted Mueller, Robert Mueller, for his phony, fraudulent Russian collusion witch hunt. We've indicted Joe Biden, his son Hunter, and his brother James for a massive racketeering bribery scheme from communist China, Russia, Ukraine. Want to know why no action's taken with China? Because he's bought and paid for by the butchers of Beijing. We've indicted Fauci, that's coming down the line very shortly, right after the summer holidays, for lying to the American people. If American citizens can be held accountable under 18 U.S.C. 1001, given 10 years for each lie to the government, then shouldn't the government be treated the same way in reverse? And that's where the laws of nature and nature's God come in. As it says in our Declaration of Independence, when in the course of human events, the sovereign, the rulers, no longer represent the people, they have a God-given right under the laws of nature and nature's God to alter or abolish that government and to form a new government by and for the people with equal rights for everyone in pursuit of life, liberty, and happiness. I know I say this many times, but I want you to take it to heart. This is our God-given right to rise up peacefully and legally. And we can do it if we do it in mass. And we tell this administration and this government, your time is up. It's time to leave. The American people now are in control of our fate. Just as the people of Poland did during the Soviet Union when they went into the streets peacefully and they told the Soviets, your time is up. And Pope John Paul II said the same thing. Your time is up. Well, the time of Biden and Harris and the left is up, and the time of the Republican Party is up too. They're a bunch of corrupt court jesters and fools. How many emails do you get every day asking for money? What has the Republican Party done for you? We need new parties, and I'm going to start a new one, a separate organization, and call it the New American Independence Party. I already have the name. We need to rise up, ladies and gentlemen. It takes a revolution, forget the scandal industry. Turn off Sean Hannity. We don't need to hear the Democrats saying we're throwing Granny over the cliff one more time. Let's figuratively and peacefully throw the government over the cliff run by Democrats and Republicans and reestablish our own government by and for the people. And that's why we held a Third Continental Congress in Philadelphia on July 5th and 6th of this year at the Visitor Center of Independence Hall. Go watch that at freedomwatchusa.org and support our citizens' grand juries. We're going to try these criminals. We're going to seek indictments. We're going to give sentences out. It's going to be done fairly and under the rules of the laws of nature and nature's God. And then we will ask law enforcement who have had it, established law enforcement, police, military, others who know what's going on. They know the country's being turned into a communist dictatorship, to enforce those sentences. We will do everything peacefully and legally. But now is time to act. Now is not the time, Mark Levin, to say, let's just protest, let's just boycott, let's just complain. Sorry, it's not enough. Go read my book, It Takes a Revolution to Forget the Scandal Industry. Read Marx, too. He chronicles Marxism. We know Marxism's in this country right now. But it's time to act. God bless you. God bless your family. God save your family. You're going to need it. And it's time that we invoke the divine providence like our founding fathers did. Because without God and without His Son, we have no hope. I'll be back tomorrow with another YouTube broadcast. Thank you for listening to me.